cars we can break into.
Steal your mixtapes.
No, that's totally out. That's a jam. You put that on and you're just like, oh, the world's problems are fading away.
And out of your head, somebody's dancing and singing and not paying attention to this. Three times it's happened. Three times.
Welcome to the show, everybody!
Here tonight, starting with me introducing myself on this right side. I am Draven.
Sophie.
Will.
Kat.
Leo.
Hannah.
Catherine.
Christian.
Lou.
Adley.
Akshay.
Dylan.
Cameron.
Alex.
Adrian. Yeah, we're doing some fun shows for you, just in case you're not familiar with Spontaneity at all. We are a locally based Halifax improv school. We teach levels from beginner up to our performance teams.
We have musical improv.
You don't have to sing.
One note, that's all you get. You want the rest? Sign up.
Don't have to sing. We'll be good at singing.
We're based in Lighthouse just down the road. 1-800, Argyle Street. We're just down the road. 1800 Argyle Street.
1-800 extra zero.
Toll free.
Top of the world. 1-800-12. Okay. Yeah, so if you see what you like on stage, you too could also be up here one day. Check it out. SpontaneityImprov.ca.
Thank you. To get the show started, we're going to play a little warm-up game. It's a backline game. It's called This Next Bit. And we'll clear the boxes and we'll get this started. Bring a round of applause to get started. For this next bit, it is two bees that are fighting over one flower.
There's somebody on the plane, they lost their Apple Watch in the crack between the seats.
Beep, 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 beep,
beep. Excuse me, can I help you?
Yeah, I know, this is kind of weird, but I just lost it, and I don't know if it'd be a bother, but could you just shove your hand in the dirty, gross seat and get it for me?
Oh, oh, I know. That's okay. I do it all the time. I do it all the time. Okay. I'm going to need you to stand back.
For this next bit is someone finding a beautiful, one-of-a-kind item in the clearance section.
Can I go to that, boss?
speak in palindromes except for this sentence. Race car! Race car! Race car! Race car!
Excuse me, I'm here for the audition for Manic Pixie Dream Girl number 2.
Oh, yeah. That's next door.
For this next bit, we have a child detective solving his first adult crime.
Oh!
Oh my god!
I see the victim was immortalized using tomato sauce.
Oh my god!
Oh no!
You did it again, Detective Jimmy.
That's why you pay me in lollipops, Detective Johnson.
That's right. You can call me Dad.
This next bit explains one specific circus's clown hierarchy.
All right, boys, you got your happy clowns, and you got your sad clowns, and you got your silent clowns, all right? You bozos, this is how this is going down around here.
Well, what about clowns that spray little flowers?
Well, are you happy or are you sad? You can do a lot of bits between a happiness or sadness. Are you going to make the kids cry, or are you going to make them laugh, or are you going to make them... Try and figure out what you're doing.
I'm one of the clowns that's down in the sewer. Where do I fit?
Oh, shit!
For this next bit, a ship captain and a humpback whale have an awkward situation at a four-way stop.
Shopping cart, puppy, powerhouse, Peanut.
Puppy.
And Puppy.
Puppy.
Puppy times two.
Oh! Poultry!
Poultry! There it is!
One more time.
Peanut. Poultry, peanut, powerhouse, shopping. And
Puppy!
Puppy! All right, and there it is.
I saw you had a bunch of, are you like shopping for puppies as well? Or?
Yeah, I'm definitely shopping for an animal.
You look good though. You're looking for, you're settling down, I'm guessing, is that what's going on?
Yeah. I mean, I guess I've been doing that and seen.
Things are good for you and working out, things are, your life is great right now.
I've seen your business is going great online. I've seen you.
Yeah, you know, we're trying to attract, like, you know, people to come to this small town and, you know, trying to invest in the local,
a puppy. I love puppies.
Yeah. Are you in the market for a puppy? Is that what's
Well, no. Obviously, I was buying food for the puppy, so I'm definitely not looking for.
Is that so? You're allowed to bring puppies in here. I feel like you're.
Shopping cart.
Wow, this looks like. Is that puppy?
My puppy wallet.
Is that puppy like trying to get into?
One second. Can you just pull it off?
Look, if that puppy is trying to get it invest in local businesses, I'm the man.
I know you're the man, Akshay, you're the man.
Well,
and I'm thriving, really.
Yeah, no, I know. I've seen your Instagram. I've seen you and all your, you know, everything that you're doing. Your poultry shop is like popping right now.
Yeah.
But you know, if things are not like, sometimes you want to put up a facade of things, but if.
What?
Yeah, you know, sometimes people put up a facade and you don't know what's going on behind the scenes.
Are you guys gonna buy anything or should I just continue pretending to scan something?
Yeah, I've been making 5 laps around the store, guys, come on. I've seen stray dogs.
We cut to the poultry shop. Anybody actually work here?
Hi.
Oh, hi! I expected you behind the counter, not beside me.
I was doing something in the aisle, sorry.
Okay. I need a lot of chicken.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's what I thought I needed too.
I bought a lion. I don't know what they eat. I'm assuming chicken.
Well, I'm just a regular citizen in this grand old book or something. How do you... Excuse me. How about you ask the lion what he wants?
Do you want a wing or a breast?
Lots of chicken breasts, okay?
You can communicate with a lion, and I couldn't even communicate with... Fine.
I was drunk when I bought this.
Cut to the moment when you bought the at the exotic animal place.
Step right up right here. Get your very own breasty lion. Just right here. The breast of a truth right off his mane. He's amazing. He's doing it, gone.
Oh. It's like that movie Wizard of Oz.
Oh, hey, this ain't no fictional motion picture there, buddy. This lion's got groom, he's got tail, he's got, you know, character.
The Cowardly Lion was a character.
True. Say, you look like a nice sober fella.
Yeah.
Would you like to perhaps buy this fantastic beast here?
Can I get a hot dog?
Absolutely you can.
I'm just a regular citizen out roaming this lion shop, this circus shop. I say, you buy it.
Yeah. What do you say, Breasty? What do you say for yourself?
No.
What?
It's yours.
Wait, did he just talk English? I feel like if I were in a situation where I needed to know what he eats, it speaking English would be very useful.
He's very temperamental. He likes to talk. Sometimes he doesn't.
Oh, okay. I only know thank you in this sentence.
Well trained. Where's my hot dog?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Sorry. Doo-doo. There you go. You stop holding that.
Yeah.
Be gone. I swung
it. Wait, please. Does the elephant talk? You trained the elephant to talk? This is the best circus ever.
Anybody got a peanut?
We zoom in on the hot dog and zoom out on a PCA fundraiser.
So, Nancy, how have you been doing the cupcakes? I'm doing the brownies right now.
Well, I just used my, you know, my great-grandmother's old, you know, special cupcake recipe. You know, I thought it'd be something special, you know, since it's for kids. I know you're hypercritical of everything that I make for these fundraisers, but I really think this time, Patricia, this time I think it's going to be good enough. Well, I show to you my peanut butter chocolate chip cupcakes.
I'm really sorry, Nancy, but I'm sure you know that this is a peanut-free lion.
NFTs are not selling. I minted so many NFTs for this PTA meeting, and they are not going.
Well, you can tell me at least that they're peanut-free, right?
Oh, they are definitely all peanut characters. It's like Mr. Peanut, but with like different wigs and
Cut to Nancy and Patricia in high school like 30 years ago.
Oh, hey Patricia. Oops, your milk spilled all over your face.
Cool.
I don't know what I would ever do if I lost this crown.
Yeah, that crown is cool.
Right?
It's made out of peanuts. Peanuts aren't even allowed in this school.
Well, the principal lets me do what I want.
That's
so
right.
I'm the queen of the school.
And I'm the principal. Sorry, I guess I'm so used to saying your name all the time.
We cut to the principal in high school.
Oh, hey, Jurgen.
That's me, Jurgen.
I heard you were trying to start a little bake drive here at the Baking Festival of 1802.
Yes,
Old
yes. And we just, I thought it would raise everybody's spirits after the plague, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was really hard getting through that, but, smallpox, large pox, mid pox.
Oh, my God, Dylan, I didn't know you were so strong.
Oh, yeah, I'm on the varsity churning team.
Like those guys?
Those guys.
Give me some butter for the bake drive if you guys might. If you guys could churn some for me, that would be great.
I suppose we can help you out.
Yeah?
All right. So what's in it for us?
Not getting the plague?
Butter churning business not going as planned. Okay.
All
so,
right.
Yeah.
Bad news.
I understood some of those words.
Lace Lions.
Thomas City's dairy firm. Okay. Butter. The butter is solid. Very hard to churn.
You have bonbons?
Weak.
Lion. Here's a solid brick of butter. You ate all the poultry in the town, so.
Petit peanut.
We don't allow those in school, but.
Yeah. It looks like.
Mon ami.
A powerhouse.
Thomas of a house of a fester power. Thomas lioness. Feline power, you see. Feline power.
Let's see. Or Facebook Marketplace.
Oh, honey. Remember about that puppy that I wanted so very badly?
Yeah.
Well, I've checked this new site out called the Facebook Kijiji.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What are you, so are you looking, you're looking on Kijiji for puppies?
No.
Okay.
It's like a thing. It's like both.
Okay. What are the selections?
Well, you see, I can't really see them.
Oh, okay. So maybe we can go visit some of these, if you have a short, maybe, how about this one? This is like a nice border collie over here.
The picture is
real. Like,
I'm not sure. That looks like a deer in the headlights.
Well, you can't trust Facebook Kijiji these days. I feel like there's all kinds of sketchy people on there. But what speaks to you right now?
Oh, I like this one right here with the stone guy.
All right, maybe we can go meet them. Let's do that.
What type of dog is it?
It's a Dachshund.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, let's go meet this stoner guy with the dasher.
Okay.
A stoner
guy with the dasher.
Hey!
I am just a regular.
Who's my talk? Keep saying that.
Whoa, you know what? I'm sold right now.
We'll take him.
Finally, a sale for the PTA.
Wait. What about my dog? What about my dog? Yeah, it's Jack.
I think.
Oh, wow, surprise seeing you here.
Oh, yeah. My gosh.
Hey, wait a minute.
Awkward.
Whoa. Oh, sacra balls. Oh, my God. Oh, wait, I forgot. I'm sorry.
My life is a lie.
Wait a minute. Oh, no, it's just an
actual lie. Oh, my God.
Oh, oh, my God.
That's butter?
Performers. Do you want to start with a little bit of inspiration for yourself?
What book am I reading?
Moby Dick.
Moby Dick. Thank you.
Excellent. Whenever you're ready, take it away.
I think my finger is in each page. COVID ain't a thing, I tell you.
Excuse me, sir. Hi. Oh, wait, perfect height. Sorry, there's just an itch right here. Can you get it, please, for me? It's just
itch. Oh my God!
Oh, that felt good. I've been going to see a chiropractor at least 3 times a week, and it hasn't done anything. How did you learn that?
No, you see.
Sorry, just wait a minute.
You're reading a book, I see it. I love reading. You see, I was a librarian in a rough part of the town.
Oh. And is that how you learned how to really manipulate those bones?
Well, you see, I would get hit in the back with books every day.
Not the coolest kid on the block, I see, no?
No, the librarian never gets any respect from the cool kids.
Ain't that the truth? The librarians are always the last one in line for everything.
Put a quote down in your book.
Hit me with it.
Ow, my back!
My back!
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go to chiropractic.
I love you. Can a tall, handsome stranger.
Oh, hey, cat.
Oh, Carl. Hi.
Mind if I take a seat?
Oh, don't I ever.
Oh. Whoa, what's with that book?
Oh, yeah. Okay, so, well, listen, this is the book that I'm writing. It's actually kind of like a memoir, but I just met this guy named Carl, and then he told me that he was so good at a chiropractor, and he was a librarian. Isn't that great? Oh, by the way, do you know of an osteopath I could use? Because, you know, my feet are also begging for some love,
That librarian sounds cool.
Right, he was a librarian and a chiropractor. So the...
Oh, I got it.
Listen, are you going to give me the wreck or not?
Maybe.
Oh, yeah.
If I'll...
Carl, listen. It was a lovely night that one time. It lasted for fucking ever.
See ya.
Strollers everywhere.
Oh, hey, buddy.
How's it going, Carl?
Nice seeing you here.
Yeah.
I just saw Kat.
Oh, yeah. Hey, she was she hanging out with that dorky librarian guy?
Isn't she always? Anyways, yeah. How's the baby stomping?
It's all right. Pays the bills.
You know, my sister-in-law is having a baby.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I gave her your card.
Nice.
Oh, look at that. A call about the baby.
Yeah, you keep me in the loop, Carl.
I will.
Have I got a deal for you?
Okay. So
okay.
Here's the deal. Here's
I'm
the deal.
Gonna give you 500 lollipops if you give me $10,000, and then you're gonna sell each of those lollipops, okay, for more to make a profit. But here's the secret. Every person you sell to, you also have to get $10,000 from them and give them 500 lollipops. It's really not hard, just keep following. Once they get more people, as soon as they get one, they have to sell the lollipop and then get $10,000 from them. And then, and then it's all gonna go right down, and then you all give me your $10,000, and it's like a seed, you know? And it's just gonna grow and grow, and you're just never gonna have to work a day in your life.
I have to go find some people to get lollipops from.
Yay! Gold tier, baby. Get in that vacation home.
And then Moby said, "Wow, that really is a literal last name." Antsy.
Alright, so for the next game, we're gonna play a game called Last Line, First Line. So, quick, intermingle and then split into two teams.
Done.
So the way that this game works is we're actually going to be seeing two scenes happen. Not at once, but pretty close. To start things off... quick, someone raise a hand. You guys are faster, you first. Alright, so the way this game works, when I yell switch, we're going to switch between the two scenes that are going to be happening. The last thing said before I say switch will have to be the very first thing said after I said switch. Makes sense?
Yeah.
Now, before we get started, you're the first team, so I'll give you a bit of inspiration. You guys are just going to be inspired by whatever line is being said. From the audience, can I get a dream you've had recently?
Airport, left my backpack and my passport there. It was dispersed among all these people, and then I got it all back.
Airport anxiety. All right, so when I yell switch, switch. Last thing you said becomes the first thing you said. I wasn't here.
Please enter your pockets. All bags, laptops, please put them in separate bins. Remove your socks, remove your belt. If you are wearing an underwire bra, remove that as well. There are privacy codes to your right. If anybody needs an extra bin, please holler for Earl. He will come with an extra bin.
Sorry, it was shoes on, belts off, glasses, do they?
Again, ma'am, it is belts off, shoes off, socks off, underwire bras off, earrings off, jewelry off, glasses off, contacts out.
My phone, I...
Phone in a separate bin, please, ma'am. iPads in a separate bin.
Excuse me, sir. I'm sorry. I have inflows at the beginning of COVID, and this is getting a little bit hectic. Can you please just hold my stuff for 2 seconds?
Absolutely. I just,
Oh my gosh.
Do we have to stay fully nude the whole time?
Switch!
No! Oh no!
Fully nude the whole time.
Oh no!
That's what the contract says. Maybe if we just kind of position differently.
Okay, okay.
Ladies.
I'm gonna keep covering my bits.
It's for a movie class, and it's the artistic new drawing. That was the next room over, but you're in the wrong spot. But my model's canceled on me anyway, and I have to make this horror movie. So
this could work.
Yeah, do we look good enough to be in your movie?
Yeah, there's only one answer to that.
It's okay if you say no.
Switch.
It's totally okay if you say no. I understand that I have 3 huge bags with me, but I really need to go to the bathroom and I can't hold it any longer. Can you please just stay with them?
I don't have a choice right now. I mean, if I drop it, this is gonna cause like an earthquake.
Fantastic. Sorry. I just gotta. Oh my gosh.
You can just do that.
With everything that you are holding currently?
Right over here, sorry.
Beep, beep, beep. There's a suspicious item in aisle number 3. Our piece
of item. Oh, there's a suspicious item in here? Really? Oh, wow.
Aisle number 3, you said?
Yes, please.
I'm on it. Excuse me, sir. May I just... Perfect. This way, please. Alright, let's see what's in here. Okay, someone's shopping. These are nice pants, by the way.
Switch! These are nice pants, by the way.
These are nice pants!
Yeah, at least we can wear pants for this.
Yeah, we are topless, but...
I decided to roll with it and call the movie The Topless Top Head Killers. You guys decapitate a lot of people.
Oh, okay, nice!
Yeah, we know! Alright!
Who wants to get decapitated first? Just step right after the shopping mall.
I mean, you're my good friend. I don't know that I really want to decapitate
you. No, but honey, darling. Right. You're acting.
It's not a snuff film. I hate you. Don't touch my boobs.
Cut. It's just me. Sweet, darling. What's wrong? This is what you wanted to be, a topless serial killer, isn't it?
Yeah.
Accidentally, when you stumbled in.
When I looked into your eyes, I said, that's my future.
Switch!
Listen, when I started this job back in 02, I really said, that's my future, looking at this pair of pants, goddamn, ain't it just. Listen, Carla, can you hold these for me? Sorry, alright. Make sure I'm not gonna do it, not gonna,
I just wanna go to Waterloo.
Switch!
I just want to go to Waterloo!
Is that the new Walker?
Yeah.
Listen, once we film this, I promise you, the sequel, Waterloo gets Blutterloo, right? I'm telling you, it's going to be great. You won't be in it. You're not in the part.
Because I'll be dead.
You'll be
Switch!
Dead.
Hi, you'll be dead for this!
Carla, come here. A 56 milliliter bottle of water.
Rookie mistake.
What were you gonna plan to do with this?
I promised it was a lady and she gave me these 300 pounds of luggage.
The person last week said the same thing.
Everybody every week says the same thing.
Switch!
Here, let's switch.
Okay, let's switch. I'm going to try being the killer now.
Okay, yeah.
Alright, and your line was?
Fine.
Everybody every week tries this?
Yeah, because I think it's your turn to try, because everybody every week tries this.
Oh, everybody every week tries this.
So, yeah. What's my motivation now?
Your motivation is that you're tired of being the headless top killer, and now it's time for you to be the bottomless bottom feeder, and you.
Alright, for this next game, we couldn't decide which game to go for, so we combined two. So we're gonna combine back two games here. So I had the other teams write a couple lines in here, I wrote a few myself, so these improvisers have never seen these before. I hope they were kind. So we're going to play a combination of the game called Draven, you're cut.
Honestly, fair. Because I wrote most of them.
This is fair.
Draven, you're cut?
I'm cut.
Yeah, I'll take yours.
All right, so the way this game works, we're going to play Freeze mixed with pocket lines. So we're going to start with two improvisers on the stage. Whoever's feeling frisky. Oh, yes. One and two. Lovely, lovely. Out a scene, at any point the other improvisers are going to yell freeze, but also during the scene they're going to reach into their pocket, pull out one of those pieces of paper, and read whatever's on there and try to do their best to justify it. I'm so sorry. Could I get an occupation from the audience to get them started?
Dentist.
Gardener.
I hear dentist. Let's go with dentist. Whenever you're ready, dentist.
Do we have today?
Oh, I think there's just one, but it's taking all day because it's I really don't want to tell you this. It's Mr. Smith. He's coming back. He's gonna try.
How does he have any teeth left, Wendy?
We just keep filling that one over and over.
dentist after that.
I know. One of the things he always keeps saying is, whoops, my pocket mayo spilled everywhere. and once he screams that, everybody just like freaks out.
And I'm the one slipping on the mayo.
I know.
My sterility's gone, and that's why I'm always washing my head.
Creepy.
L-O-V. yeah. Wait, is this the right... Wait, do you think if mom and dad come home, they're going to be able to read this? L-O-V.
Anniversary banner and stuff.
I think when they come in, they'll be really shocked to see the two of us ready to do this.
You know, I think we did such a good job on this happy 40th banner that we hung up there.
I know, mom and dad are gonna be so excited.
It'll be so good.
Did you hang that on mom's brand new wallpaper? I just, she's gonna not be happy about this. Did you use the double-sided tape? Please don't tell me you didn't use the double-sided tape.
No, I'm a 6-year-old. I used a hammer and nails. What else?
Hammer and nails. How did you get
it? I got it. Wait. Hold on.
We can also see their letter costumes are made out of fancy wallpaper.
Gosh, man, we made these really tight. Listen, Carly, can you help me just get up on this?
I know, but I think, you know what? Mom's going to really be happy we used a really expensive wallpaper she just ordered from Amazon.
I mean, listen, we look good.
We look good.
Oh, do you want this one?
Oh, did you? All right, dang it.
Okay. Are you taking my thing?
There's nothing better than fly fishing. Water up to your waist.
Yeah, I just feel very seasick. Even though we're standing in water.
No, that's all right. You know, sometimes I look at the rippling of the water and, gosh, Yeah, shoot, yeah. Oh god, okay. Well, you haven't caught anything yet, and I would feel a little remiss going back to your mother without, you know, so much as a little, like, sardine.
Yeah, we gotta feed her, because then if we don't, she'll say, knock, knock. Oh no, you know what knock, knock means.
Who's there? Not fish, that's for sure. I think, hey, you know what will bring her spirits up? A little phrase from the book of Isaiah.
Oh, praise be.
Chapter 8, verse 32. Look, a distraction. Yep.
Look at me.
Look, a distraction. What do you think that is? I think it's a UFO. You think it's a UFO?
It very much could be.
But they have it painted like a hot air balloon.
It's incredible. It's and I have my wallet sticking out of my back pocket so far, and I'm not worried about it because I'm looking at that.
Nobody's gonna come by.
All right, we're going for two plates.
Two plates. Do you want me to put the second plate on top?
You think you can get the... Yeah,
I can try.
Okay,
can you just...
Wait.
Wait.
We can see there are like 30 broken plates at their feet.
Listen, okay. It's not working. The captain said that in order to get two plates... Can you read that for me?
I can. Finally, only reindeer know laugh in fridge temperature.
See, the reindeer freaking know how to do it. Why can't I?
Okay, I'm going to spin them. I'll spin them.
All right, ready?
Okay. Yeah,
3, 2. Oh, my God.
Shit, that's not gonna work.
Oh.
Freeze.
Oh, that's hurt. My darling. No, please.
I love when you and I just stand in our beautiful living room and recreate the creation of Adam.
Nothing more sensual.
Or I'll be real quick.
Wait, my love.
Not my hands.
All right, for our last game, we're going to be playing a game called Superhero Funeral. Sounds sad, I promise. It'll be fun. I hope. Alright, okay. So we're attending a superhero funeral. Could I get the name of the superhero who's died? An unconventional superhero.
Band-Aid Man.
Band-Aid Man? Beautiful. So the way this game works is we're going to give a eulogy, then we're going to name another superhero, and that's going to endow the next person who's going to come up and give their eulogy for very short Band-Aid Man. Are we all ready?
Yes.
Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us today. We're here to mourn and celebrate the life of a true hero, Band-Aid Man. Now, up first to discuss is his sidekick, the Scuffed Knee Kid.
You know, I was stuck on Band-Aid Man. Band-Aid Man stuck with me. I remember when Band-Aid Man picked me out of a crowd of kids. You know, when superheroes hold babies. And he picked me to hold, and he said, oh, you're gonna make it one day. And there I was at a superhero training camp, wearing my Band-Aid cape. I got Band-Aids on my scraped knees. I always had a scraped knee. But you know, he was always there for me. Just like First Aid Kit Man was.
Oh, scuff knee kit, please. Tissues. Oh, no, your knees, please. It's I. First aid kit, man. It's not a first aid kit, it's a pack of cigarettes. You see, Band-Aid Man died heroically, stopping a hydraulic press. Fortunately, rather than trying to hold it open with his super strength, he instead stacked Band-Aid after Band-Aid after Band-Aid on top of each other to stop the press from destroying the town's prize diamond. I scream, Band-Aid Man! It's not worth your life. It's a blood diamond anyway. Not because it's from Africa. It's because Great Knee Kid was interacting with it earlier.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Those were my last words to him. But the last words that he heard were of his arch nemesis, Hemoglobin Boy. I'm so sorry. Somebody that's at the funeral just raised their hand. I would love to hear whatever you have to say, funeral goer.
Oh, I thought arch nemesis was Furry Fury. But...
Yes. He had two arch nemesis. First, we'll hear from Fury.
Furry Fury,
the hairiest villain that ever existed.
Boom!
You know, Band-Aid Man, this was just going to be another one of my devious contraptions that you were going to find your way out of, but, hoo-wee, hydraulic presses, they do not have any give. They just, they keep going. But super glad that I got an invite to this. For me, this is kind of like a homecoming for me, where I get to kind of be the victorious one. So I did prepare something, I think. Then I'll hand it off to Hemoglobin Boy over there. I think you'd like this one. I'm pooping myself. Yeah, I'm pooping myself. There is so much poop. And it isn't stopping. Keep it going, boy.
That was pretty good. Band-Aid Man, how am I going to live without you? All I do now is bleed and hang out with, like, Scrape Knee Kid. Oh. I thought Scrape Knee Kid.
Oh.
and what really makes is your arch nemesis. I mean, maybe I should hang out with him. A lot of Band-Aids are still stuck on his fur. Do you think that will help me? And for
It's a cigarette. Nothing, it's just cigarettes.
It's just a cigarette. What am I going to do with that? So, all I can do is say, I'm now sick as frick. Dude! I'm really sad you're gone. And I think you need to talk to your sister, Super Gauze. sorry.
Don't help me. No, I all soaked it up. Sorry.
Thanks, boss.
My brother.
Yeah.
I was wanting to do that funeral. You were taken from this earth too soon. You didn't get to cover it. That's cats in the world.
Got a few of his own, though. Oh!
Listen, Furry Fury, I know you can only use gauze because of your furiness, but I'm not talking to you right now. I'm talking to my mother.
Self-adhesive gauze. He was always the better of us. And now it's just me. Left to soak up in the blood of the world. I'm here for you to create me.
Thank you.
I'm here for you.
We bleed and we
get together. I don't know if I can say any more things, so I was reading down for my brother that he's gonna understand. You know it. You know it. It's the best inside joke we ever had. The best one we ever had. You have the hair of a dog. Heart. Okay. That's enough of me. I have to end off this beautiful memorial service. Our mother. The grand nurse.
You were supposed to be here at 0800.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, not me.
Save it, please. Thank you very much. Now listen. All right. I know that you did so much good for people in the world. Well, and for words too. You were quite the linguist. But for the world, I mean, just look at this ragtag, scrappy, hairy individuals. I mean, just look at this great knee kid. Where are, oh, of course, the band-aids, they give it away. Jeez. I just gotta call Child Protective Services. You know, but that's okay. Not my circus, not my monkeys. Yeah? Okay, so listen, my darling. You have done so, so much good in the world.
Yeah.
So I need you to rest easy. Mm-hmm. Good. And I need you to put in a good word with the big guy. Because between you and me, I've killed too many people. No, I'm not getting in there. So can you just do this one last thing for your mumsy? Yeah. I will hold it with me forever. So listen. From me to you. Just don't fuck up the afterlife for us. Yeah. Okay, well. So nice seeing you for the last time, and from all of us here at Crickshank's funeral home. I'm so sad you're going to miss Karaoke Wednesdays. It's my favorite time of the week. We just wanted to thank you for your service and for all of the love that you gave, well, me. I'm sorry, but your sister just didn't quite get very much. So, anyways, thank you. And if I have any parting words for you, you already said that one. Nothing like a handful of oatmeal.
meet every, you guessed it, Sunday.
Sunday.
Can you believe we've had one class?
Whoa, well practiced.
Well, I was going to reel that after if we did really well.
He did number two.
Thanks for coming. Can I get a couple words just to inspire some monologues from us, and then we'll get some. Whoa, put all those there! Cat, I swear, you and your identical twin, I got words to say to you. Are you guys sisters?
You and Cat,
like the audience member. No, you're actually not. You're so confused right now. Sorry, I was like so excited. You guys look identical. Look at them, everybody. They're screaming at you.
Everyone, Draven, make it some awkward for you.
If you'd like yell some words to get our monologues inspired, you don't have to raise your hand like Cat's sister.
Twin.
Pickles.
Mustache. Pickles.
Awkward.
Awkward.
Raven's mustache, flexible, awkward. We got it.
We got it.
Right, round of applause. So I have twins. I have twins. I have four. This is my fourth baby coming. I'll just tell you guys about my life a little bit. I moved here 7 years ago from Toronto, and I was like single AF. I was like 36 years old.
Yeah.
Just like, I'm gonna move to Halifax and see what it's like. I came out here one time. It's just so pretty. Whatever, and I did. And then 50 days after I moved here, I went on a Tinder date with a guy who was like, okay. he didn't talk very much, and we went on a 2:00 in the afternoon date, and at the old Lion's Head before it was remodeled. And I ordered. Are we all adults here? I was trying to be a classy lady. And so I had a couple of afternoon pints, and I started to be a little less classy, and I was like, don't fuck this guy, you're classy. And so I ordered chicken fingers. Yeah, that's what I would normally order. I was looking for the wings, but I thought, no, it's too messy, like, be classy. So I had chicken fingers.
Classy chicken fingers.
And little did I know that...
It's an aphrodisiac.
Today was an aphrodisiac. I did fuck him. Anyways. many, many times since then, because after a few months, he was just, like, so nice and kept hanging around, and one day I was like... It took 3 months, and I was like, oh shit, like, this guy makes my, like, he's so nice to me, and every day is easier because he's here. I guess love isn't all the pain and angst and drama that I thought it was for, like, for my whole life to that point, and I was just like, oh my god, cool. And here we are with our fourth baby on the way.
Yeah.
We have two kids, and this all happened in the last couple years. So it's been a bit of a mind fuck. So I'm a little, because I have so many children. But also, he told me that he knew that I was the one because chicken fingers are his favorite. He was like, she's the one. So it was serendipitous that I was trying to be classy or religious. Thank you.
Welcome to this fancy museum with a restaurant attached to it. Welcome, we have a ball pit at the front. You may jump in it, might be wet. And for dessert, we only have spaghetti.
I love the children's drawings colored on the wall.
Yes, what do you think this finger painting says?
Oh.
Speaks, not literally, because there's probably words in there, but, like, what it says to you.
It's calling out my inner child, the demon in me. It's saying, let's eat dirt.
Speaking of eating, what do you want to order?
Oh, we've been sitting here forever.
I thought you wanted to let it cook and admire this children's museum.
Yeah, the ball pit's really cool. It's been a while in there.
Don't go in there. We still need to clean it. So what can I get you to order?
Thanks. What's the, like, least messy option you have?
spaghetti.
Do you have anything, I don't know, something classy like chicken fingers?
Or we have spaghetti with meatballs.
That's not close.
No. Good job. Chicken's a meat.
Can you squish them into finger shapes?
Squish them into.
That was a question. Okay, I guess that's a yes.
I wrote it down. It's in there. All right, we only take orders with crayons.
I guess I'm getting spaghetti.
Excellent choice. Excellent choice. And was that just a question, or did you want?
I guess I'll get them too. You wrote it down.
I did. It's permanent crayon.
They're sitting in like those craft like chair, like the little tiny chairs with the little tiny play table, and it has the brown paper over it with crayon in the middle.
Do you want a cheers with the classic
tea? Oh yeah, absolutely. It's so nice of them to serve beer to us in this.
Really follow me though.
More?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, that's not
fair. It's a teapot. No, we were told you didn't have them.
No, they don't have them. But if you come to the back alley, chicken fingers.
Come to the back alley!
Alright.
Darling, do you think this is safe?
Darling, this is the first date, no, pretty quick.
We're already doing a drag deal for chicken fingers. I think we passed the threshold.
Actually, a large crowd.
Yeah, there's a lot of people here for chicken fingers. It's all the Mickey stuff. They have the chickens!
That means they're fresh, right?
Yeah, but we have to get the finger parts.
I don't know how food works.
Hi, did you hear about the back alley chicken fingers?
It was literally you that told us.
Oh, sorry. I tell everyone.
It's like 20 minutes ago.
Yeah, I tell everyone.
Yeah.
I just want to say, I know you're new to the city. This doesn't happen that often. Okay, it does.
Oh.
Actually, this is the third date that this has happened.
You take a lot of people to this restaurant?
It's the only one in town!
With the back alley chicken fingers?
Yeah!
Oh, nice to see you, Carl!
Wow, a regular, I see.
So, Carl, are we going to do the regular deal for the... the dinosaur-shaped one.
Your regular date deal?
I see how it is.
Guys, be cool.
Okay.
I think this one might actually like chicken fingers.
Whoa.
You're wrong. I love chicken.
Wait a sec. Did she say she loves chicken fingers?
What the hell are we going to do then? We'll have to stop pushing them on people. People love chicken fingers.
Wait a
minute.
Well,
you know what? You might have to push them still, because I don't know if I want to eat chicken fingers with this man who goes out with so many chicken finger loving women.
Well, three dates over 10 years. I'm lonely.
I haven't dated anyone in 10 years.
I waited.
It's the connection. This is the connection we've been waiting for.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That means she's a keeper, because it's the first... Girl, we've seen like chicken fingers!
Alright, who's on the date here? Me or you?
Girl, she's the keeper!
You have to propose! Don't worry, we'll play the wedding!
I'm really hungry, Rob.
The chicken here!
Rob, wait, my ex cup? Okay.
You told me your name was Robert Carl. I didn't know you went by
your last name. No, you called her by the last names here.
That's true. I'm sorry, I corrected you. This chicken finger has a ring in it.
Yeah!
Look, I'm just really hungry, okay?
Love is angst. Love is horrible.
Love is pain!
Really cramping my songwriting sesh.
Oh, come on! Have a little sympathy!
Betty was a real special lady!
Well, and Betty was also my sister.
Gross! Well, then don't ask me to add any lyrics to your dirty music, because I can fill it with some stuff that I filled your sister.
What do you want?
Dad! Mom says you have to come out of the basement for dinner!
That's right, I'm writing down what you want.
Betty.
Don't tell me that you have Josh in there because I told him I never wanted to see him again.
Why are you putting me in the middle of this? I hate you. Get out of the basement.
Betty!
Well, that's kind of weird because that's my sister, but.
My sister stuff and all right.
Okay, I'll start.
I'll be like, it'll work for on like multiple levels, okay. You know?
Betty, you're so annoying when you kick the walls. But I kick down the walls to get to you. Betty! When you change the remote, the TV with the remote, I get so blue.
Betty!
You changed my life for the better, Betty.
Okay, so I've been drinking a lot of juice box at recess today.
Hold on a second.
I gotta be glassy.
I have my eyes closed, so I was really into a song. Is that a sweep? Am I out or am I in? Yeah.
Wait.
This is a sweep. Hi. Can I have some of your juice box?
Yeah.
You have two juice box?
No, I've been cranking. This is my 10.
What?
I'm trying to keep classy, but I want to ask Rebecca to play with us at recess today. I want to, but I gotta keep it classy.
Wow, dude, you're the first guy in fifth grade to develop feelings for girls. That's crazy.
I think if I asked her to recess, then I think I'm gonna give her the plastic ring that I bought.
The ring?
I gotta keep it classy, I can't do that.
Your one ring pop you get for your month's allowance?
Yeah, I think I gotta give it to that girl. Because I have feelings now.
Well, you're handing out the juice box.
No!
Okay.
I need the courage. Because I ain't gonna be classy today.
You're so much taller than me, you're a growth spurt.
Hey!
Hi, guys. So how about those dates that we had 5 years ago and yesterday?
You didn't know we were twins?
Draven, we're doing a dad-themed calendar. where we're all gonna dress up as dads, stereotypical dads. We're gonna take photos together, and then we're gonna sell it as a charity for Movember month. Oh. It was very cute. And I spent a whole year, December, because they did one the year prior. I said, I wanna get on this next year. December, I said, it's time. And it's January 2019. And I say, I'm gonna do it. A month later, I say, nope, it looks so bad, and I shaved it off. You know what happened in March? We all started wearing face coverings.
Oh.
Yeah, I stealth grew this bad boy for 2 years under a mask. Woo! Friends, family, ladies that I kissed, they knew about the mustache. But coworkers, it was whatever day we finally got rid of masking. And I showed up to work, ripping it off, revealing it. Beautiful. How long have you had that for? After 2 weeks, I got so tired of answering that question, I was ready to shave it off. But it was October 20th. I was excited for two things, Halloween and this photo shoot. And I went to the photo shoot and had a great time. Then it came time to sell the calendars. I thought, how do I drive up sales? Well, you want to get a calendar? Be the first to buy one, because nobody was buying them. Be the second to buy one, and you'll get a lock of this mustache. And I swear to you, I took dental floss and tied off each side.
Wow.
And I gave them to the first and only two people to buy calendars.
Oh my god!
And let me tell you, after the two mustache calendars went, nobody wanted them. They just wanted this. So for $500, you can get this after the show.
Honey, I've got a terrible idea. So me and the other dads, we're gonna get together, we're gonna shoot a calendar. Well, I was thinking nude. Bad idea? Not nude? Skip the nude? Skip the nude, got it. Okay. 1 second, I should come.
Hey,
sorry, I know you've been waiting like 3 hours for this. We're cutting the nude bit.
What?
Yeah, no, you gotta think of something else. What else do dads do other than be nude?
I've been growing this thing for a year, waiting for the shoot.
What thing?
Calling you your gecko one! What? Gecko scene!
Sorry, 1 second.
Gecko team!
Try again. Later.
Dental!
Did you say dental?
Oh, sorry, I'm not on speakerphone.
I'm not, I can hear in the background, bitch. Do you have a phone
for her? I don't!
How did you hurt a kid?
Cheryl says hi.
Hi, oh hey, Cheryl, what's up?
How are the kids doing?
Oh my god, growing like what? No, god, what?
Yeah, you said growing this, but you didn't specify we're on the phone. What are you growing?
Yo!
Call waiting.
Who's calling you?
Sir, none of your business. Sir, just hold a second.
Yo, bro.
Oh, dude, I've been waiting for you to phone your friend. Conference me in. I know you're talking to him.
Okay, sir, yeah. Hi guys.
Yo, what's up, dude?
Hi,
guys. I'm so excited for the new calendar that we've all been talking about.
No, I
perfectly clocked my cubic.
It's a dental team now.
Yeah, we're cutting
it's
the
dental.
New.
It's dental.
Yeah, you're shitting in my office.
Okay,
what
are you shitting in your office?
No, I know shooting.
Oh, shooting. Okay, yeah. Okay. So that's new dental. That's what we're going for now.
Wait a minute, now I'm thinking
about
shitting in Cheryl's office.
Me too, I can't get
it out of my head. You know?
Hey.
Hi.
I'm early, sorry.
Okay.
Oh, you don't want me to go again and come back in?
Whatever, you can stay.
Okay.
Yeah, so
the reason I asked you in here was that my small store is not doing very well. And as my only other employee, I'm worried that I'm gonna have to let you go.
Oh my god, wait. I thought I was coming here for like a little secret, like celebratory dinner. You sent out a really cute invite. I wore like a really nice blouse.
I know, I don't know how to send emails without flowery language and pictures.
Oh my god.
But, I have, just in case that an idea to not do that.
Oh, so like a severance package? Or?
No, okay, so there's this new thing on the internet. People really love locks of hair. And your hair is so long. Yeah. And you know, I thought maybe if we could both do it, if they purchase the things from our store and then they get a little lock of hair, and then we'll sell out. It'll be like Black Friday at Christmas.
Yeah, but you're balding.
Yeah, because I've already started.
Oh. Hi, I bought this here the other day, and it's full of hair. I want to return that.
I'm so sorry,
sir. It was cupcakes. Why would you put hair in them?
It's just this new fad that we're trying. Haven't you been on the internet, sir?
I avoid it like the plague.
Oh, then these are not for you.
Okay, you had hair last time I was here. Is that your hair?
Yes.
September 1913. When will my husband return from the war?
Jane, sorry, Upper Management sent me in to talk to you about your
I attacked a lock of hair.
I know, they think it might be a little flowery.
To remember me by.
Yeah, it's, you know, you can just like sign off, like you just have like a standard signature like that comes up every time you send an email. You don't have to be so dramatic about things.
Helen?
Yeah, you can also just sit at your desk.
It's the great one.
Jane,
the trench.
Look, I know that it's really hard for women right now to be in the business world, but we typically don't refer to it as the Great War. It's sort of insulting to the people that like fought at those times.
But what about the men?
Ellen, I mean, I'm right there with you, Jane, and it's honestly, it's not me coming from this. I think your emails are beautiful.
Thank
it's
you.
Just ugh, the boys up top are like, ugh, after something for me 4 hours and like. Like, they ask you, they don't want you to handwrite your email.
What will I do with my quill and my ink pot?
I think it brings so much character to your desk.
Yes, Helen. With my condolences, I pen this letter
to reach
you in good health.
Cut to her partner coming back from the war.
Honey, came back straight from the war.
Andrew, you made it. You're alive.
I'm sorry.
Dow. I haven't heard from you in 4 years.
It was a long war. Your brother, he saved my life. At least 4 times he got shot and then came back to life.
What about the 5th time?
Well, you see, I ran out of band-aids. I'm so sorry, Cheryl.
Did Trenchfoot get him in the end?
Yes, the bullets really just stayed off the Trenchfoot. It shot off the first broken, moldy foot. But eventually, time caught up with him. And time realized he had 2 feet.
Well, he has no feet. My dearest brother, Ronald. I pen this from beyond. It is with a longing heart.
Cease your quibbling, sister. It is I, Ronald.
Ronald, you are the one. It's still there. One of them.
Why, yes, that one was a fake one. They couldn't afford two. It's a thing.
You've replaced your foot with a lime grenade.
Yes, to get back at you, you devil. I know you've lied to my sister this whole time. The war ended 3 years ago.
The treachery.
I'm sorry, but I needed a vacation.
To retrieve these letters of love.
We've been sharing them around the trenches, actually.
Where's the lock?
Wow, Kane. Thank you so much for inviting the office to this. I think you've really found your calling.
We'd like to thank everybody for coming out, and we'll reintroduce ourselves one more time so that way you never forget who I am, starting all the way at Akshay.
Adrian.
Will.
Hannah.
Lou.
Christian.
Catherine.
Leo.
Dylan.
Sophie.
Alex.
Draven.
Adley.
Kat.
And Cameron.
And don't forget to check out spontaneityimprov.ca for classes and other shows. We do shows once a month.
We do so many shows.
A lot.
We're performing at HowlCon. If you guys have tickets, come and see us. We'll be there. We'll be doing a wrestling theme format. I promise there's no violence, just giggles.
Violent giggles.
Oh! Yes! Fight! 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 We also have a show in Nocturne that's coming up. So if you like spooky stuff, we're doing a little haunted hallway. Ooh.
That's at the Lighthouse. Festival Arts.
At 1-800.
1-800 Argyle Street.
Never live that down. And also, additionally, if you love being scared, Friday the 13th, we are doing the show that we toured in St. John, New Brunswick, in their Fun Day Fringe Festival. It's also super spooky. It's about a group of storytellers trying to tell a spooky story before midnight on October the 13th. And it's actually happening on October 13th.
Whoa!
Yeah.
So many live shows for you to check out, so check it out.